Hello, welcome to Sculpt with Sid. My name is Sydney. I'm a yoga, barre, and Pilates instructor from Toronto. And today I'm joined by my bestie, Caitlin. If you remember her from Yoga Twins days or just know us personally, you know that we've been doing yoga together forever. So she'll be here to help guide the class today. You can follow along with either of us and we'll get started down on our backs. So you can take your time to lie down. You don't need any props for today's practice, but if you're used to using blocks or straps or anything, get them set up. And then find yourself in a comfortable position where you can just take a few breaths. Once you get there, close your eyes. Slow the breath down. See if you can start to melt your body into the floor. Two more breaths like this, allowing yourself to be still. And when you're ready, start to bring some movement to the body, however you'd like. Some wiggles, some points, some circles. Good. When you're ready, hug your knees in towards your chest. You can come into a little ball, arms wrap around your shins. Can stay still or draw some circles with the knees or rock side to side, massaging your back into the floor. Good, make sure you're going in both directions if you're circling for one more breath. And find stillness. Bring your legs to a tabletop position. So knees over hips, shins parallel to the floor. Hands are gonna press onto your thighs and literally just push. We're just gonna wake up through your core. So I want you to push your hands into your thighs, resist thighs back into your hands. You'll feel a little quake come to your belly if you're pushing enough. And as you push, continue to breathe big. And think about pushing your lower back into the floor. It might not actually touch, but just to keep your low back long. One more breath pushing. Exhale, plant your feet, let your arms relax beside you. Good, keep that energy in your core. We're just gonna do a few hip rolls. So start to tuck your tailbone under, push your low back down, peel your hips up off your mat until you're in a small bridge, doesn't have to be a full yoga bridge. And then articulate through your spine to bring your hips back down. Just one more like that, waking up through the spine and the backside body, peel your hips up. And then roll it back down. Amazing. Hug your knees in towards your chest. We'll rock up and down a few times. So hands can come behind thighs, take a few rocks. You can do a bunch if it feels good. And then when you're at the top, we'll cross the ankles, plant your hands and come into a tabletop. So you can kind of just scoot your knees back. Perfect. Once you're on all fours, do a few cat-cows. Inhale, drop your belly, look up. Exhale, round your spine, look down. One more like that. Continue to wake up your spine. Neck direct your movement. Find a neutral spine on your next inhale. So right in between those two shapes. Good, we'll tuck the toes. Lift your knees just 2 inches off your mat. So you're in a little hovering tabletop. Continuing to wake up the core. Take a breath here. Pulling belly button to spine. On your next breath, downward facing, lift your hips up and back. Good, you can pedal out the knees here. Move in whatever way feels nice. Good, find stillness on your next breath. We'll move through a modified flow. On an inhale, come forward, find a high plank. Exhale, you can lower your knees, come all the way to your belly through chaturanga. Good, inhale, find a baby cobra, just pull your shoulders back. You can float hands if you want. And exhale, plant your hands, come through a tabletop and lift yourself back up to your downward facing. Good, anytime I say flow today, you can do that. Or this time we'll leave the knees lifted. Inhale, come forward, high plank. Exhale, chaturanga, just halfway through a tricep push-up. Good, inhale, upward facing, point the toes, look up. Exhale, find your downward facing. Beautiful, take a breath in your down dog. On an inhale, come high on your toes, look forward. Exhale, take as many steps as you need to find a forward fold at the top of your mat. Good, once you get there, inhale, halfway lift, hands to shins. Exhale, fold, do it twice more. Inhale, half lift, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Good, one more. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Get really soft here. Bend your knees a lot. Shake out your head. We'll ragdoll our way up to stand. Head comes up last. Just roll nice and slow. Good. Pause at the top. Find your mountain pose. Turn palms forward. Look forward. And just grow a little taller. Good. You're gonna lift your knee up to a march out in front of you, left knee lifts. Find your balance. Good, and then find your tree pose. Left foot can come to inner thigh or inner calf. You can use your hand to place it there. And then once you're comfortable, hands can come to heart center. Oh, and just breathe. Find your balance, take a breath in. On your breath out, hands can reach towards the ceiling, separate, row your tree. Good, continuing to find your balance. Ribs down, you can push your foot into your leg. Good, arms stay, come back to your march. Bring your knee out in front of you. Take an inhale here. Exhale, step back into a high lunge. Take a big step back with your left foot. Good, fingertips to the ceiling. Take a little back bend if you'd like. And then come to a straight spine. Good, we're gonna rotate here. Right arm reaches back, left arm forward. Good. Take an inhale to twist through your center. Stay twisted, left hand comes down. Find a revolved lunge. So left hand plants beside right foot and then right hand to the ceiling. You can rotate your spine even more here. Take a breath. Good, we're gonna come onto the outside of your left foot. Heel toe your right foot halfway down your mat. So you're kind of in a supported side plank. Good, we're gonna stretch out left side body. Inhale, reach your right arm towards the back of your mat. Hips come nice and low. Exhale, reach up and over towards the top of your mat. Hips come high. Yeah, good, twice more like that. Inhale, lower. Exhale, lift. One more, inhale, lower. Exhale, lift, come all the way into a high plank. Right hand plants, right foot steps back. Inhale, high plank. Good, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale up. And exhale back. Beautiful, pause in your down dog, take a breath. Maybe heels can come lower or a little warmer. On your next inhale, high on the toes, look forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift just once. Exhale, fold. Ragdoll our way up again, round through the spine, head comes up last. Good, take a breath in your mountain pose. And then find your march, right knee lifts to about hip height. Find your balance first. Good, and then tree pose, foot on the inside of your thigh or calf. Hands to heart when you're ready. Take a breath, grow taller. And if you'd like, hands to the ceiling, grow your tree nice and tall. Beautiful, shoulders down your back. Arms stay. On an inhale, right knee comes back to your march. Maybe you extend the leg straight and then take a big step back. Find your high lunge. Really good. Melt into your front knee. Take a little back bend. Inhale, look up. Exhale, return. Inhale, twist to your left. Left hand reaches back. Right hand forward. Gaze can follow your left hand. Take a breath here. And then start to hinge forward. Right hand comes down. Find your revolved lunge. You can look up towards your left hand once you get there. Continue to rotate through your spine. Good, and then let's come onto the outside of your right foot, left foot, heel, toes halfway. Inhale, lower your hips, reach to the back of your mat. Exhale, lift up and over, reach forward. Twice like that. Really try to exaggerate stretching both sides of the body with your breath. Good, one more. And then lift on up. Find your high plank. Left hand plants, left foot reaches back. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale up. And exhale back. Find your downward facing. Take a breath. Again, settling. Maybe you can come a little deeper. Good. We're going to meet on our seat. So if you have a jump through, inhale, come high on your toes, look forward. Exhale, you can jump and cross your ankles. If that's not in your practice, bring one foot forward first and then the other. Good. Yeah. And then we're going to come all the way onto our backs. Once you're here, feet plant. Cross your right ankle over your left thigh. Find a figure four. You can thread the needle if you'd like. Hands come to shin or thigh of that left leg. Just take a moment to enjoy this hip stretch on your back. I love rocking gently side to side. You'll normally find a stickier spot in your hip. You wiggle around a bit. Good, whenever you're ready, just switch sides, nice and simple. Find your other figure four. Noticing if there's any differences on this side. Just make sure your foot can stay really flexed. There's no negative tension in your knees. Good, one more breath. Unwind your legs, but stay in a little ball. One happy baby, bring your knees towards your armpits, hands to the outsides of your feet. Just rock around here, whatever makes you happy on your back. massage your back down by moving side to side. You can extend through your hamstrings by straightening one leg and the other. Maybe both. Good, whatever feels nice for one more breath. And then come back through center. Release your feet, bring your hands behind your thighs. We're gonna rock and roll up and down your spine again. This time, if you wanna jump into a chaturanga, you can cross your ankles, jump back, or do what we did earlier, cross your ankles, come through a tabletop first. If you're jumping, always try to land in your chaturanga. Move through your flow. Come on me back in your down dog. Good, take a breath here. Pull me back in your forward fold. Inhale, high on the toes, look forward. Exhale, find your forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. This time, stand up with a straight spine. Sweep your arms forward and up as you rise. And palms come through heart center. Find your mountain pose. Good. On an inhale, find your left knee in its march again. Stand up onto standing figure four. So cross your ankle over your right thigh, just like we did on our backs. Hands can come to heart as you stitch your bum back. If your hips are feeling really open today and you want, you can fold this. Bring your fingertips to the floor. Drop your head. If you're someone who loves arm balances, you can float that back leg up. One breath. If you brought your arms down, bring your hands back to heart center. We're gonna try to stay in this little bend in your right leg. Just step your left foot back, you'll be in a runner's lunge. Left leg unwinds, step it back. Yes, adjust as you need once you arrive. Then take a breath to get longer in your spine. On an exhale, twist to your right again. This time we'll hook your elbow on your thigh. If this feels okay, you can open the palms, right hand to ceiling, left hand to floor. Good, one breath here. We'll take a big windmill to land in a warrior two. So circle your arms, left heel comes down, land in your warrior two. Beautiful, flip your front palm, inhale, exhale, dance it back. Pause for a breath. We'll come up into a triangle. On an inhale, come on up, straighten your front leg. Exhale, reach forward and down, left hand high. Good, take a breath here. On your next inhale, look towards the floor. Start to bring your hands down, frame your front foot. We'll find our flow. Right foot can step back. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Good, inhale up. Exhale, back. Take a breath in your down dog. Good, inhale, high on the toes, look forward. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise with a straight spine, arms overhead. Exhale, hands through heart. Good, find your mountain pose, take a breath. Start to shift your weight to your left, right foot finds your march. Good, cross your ankle, figure four, hands can come to heart, hips can lower. Find your balance on this side, it might feel different. Decide if you wanna fold. And if arm balancing is something you're thinking about but you're not quite there, you can think about starting to make chaturanga arms. It's like a nice shelf for your right shin. One more breath. Find your balance again as you slowly roll up, hands come back to heart. Try to keep your left leg as is, right leg unwind, step it back, runners. Yes, so good. Take a breath, inhale. Exhale, twist to your left. You can hook right arm. Get comfortable there and then open the arms if you'd like. Maybe shift your gaze to the ceiling. Wherever you are, take a breath. Unwind warrior two, big windmill arms, drop your right heel, and land on your front knee. Good, inhale, flip your front palm. Exhale, dance it back. Stay for a breath. Find your triangle, lift on up. Exhale, reach forward and down. Gaze can shift to the ceiling, roll your right shoulder back, take a breath. Inhale, look down, start to bring your hands down, frame your front foot. Find your flow, left foot steps back, inhale, high plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up. And exhale, back. Pause in your downward facing. Take a breath. And then we'll meet seated again, so you can either jump or step through. Either way, inhale, high, look forward. And find your seat. We're gonna stay seated and find cow face pose. So tuck your right leg in a lot so your right heel's pretty close to your left bum. Your right knee's right in front of you. And then do the same with your left leg just on top. So cross your left leg nice and close, left heel towards bum. Knees should stack in a straight line in front of you. Once you're here, inhale, reach your arms to the ceiling. Exhale, your left arm sweeps behind you. Bend both elbows, try to find your fingertips behind your back. It's okay if they don't touch, maybe you can grab your shirt. Take an inhale, press your head back into your arm. Exhale, you can stay or fold forward if that feels okay. It'll be a pretty intense stretch for your left hip, but if you're feeling it in your knees, don't lean forward, you can definitely stay up. If you're feeling too much tension in your neck, just bring your hands down. Okay, taking a few breaths here, sending them to your left seat. On your next inhale, if you hinge forward, use it to come on up, release your hands. We're gonna do a little spin around to come to side two. So plant your right hand behind you, start to push into your feet. You're gonna come through a little fold facing the back of your mat. Keep going to the right, bend at the knees, and when you sit down, you should be on side two. If that breakdancing move didn't work for you and you're totally somewhere else, just take your time to set up with the right leg on top. Once you're there, inhale, arms reach up. This time, right hand reaches behind you. See if you can find your fingertips behind you. Maybe clasp them, or if they're not touching quite yet, just find a little energy of that left elbow reaching up. Take an inhale. Exhale, hinge forward if it feels okay. You can always release your arms if that feels better for your neck. Trying to keep both sit bones down on your mat. Good, two more breaths. One more inhale, and I will make you spin around again. Just use your exhale to come on up. Let's release your legs out in front of you this time. So give your legs a little shake if your knees felt compressed, and then we'll come back into your flow. So you can either jump into chaturanga, cross your ankles, or move through your high plank by stepping back. Meeting in your downward facing. Take a few pedals or any type of movements you normally do when we first come here and see if you've got a little extra space by now. Good. When you're ready, pause. Left leg reaches up, find a three-legged dog. Let's open the hip. If you want, you can draw some circles with that knee. Continue to release your hip. Make sure you're going in both directions if you're doing circles. One more breath. And then pause. Take an inhale here. Exhale, left knee is gonna come towards nose, find your high plank. Twice more like that, inhale up. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale up. Good, exhale, knee to nose and pause. Step the foot through in between your hands, find a warrior three. Shift all your weight into your left foot. Everything else floats parallel to your mat. Hold for a breath. Good, we're gonna come back into your march. Stand tall, right knee marches. Good, hold here for a moment. If you know you can reach for your big toe, I want you to flex your right foot, wrap peace fingers around your big toe, and then extend your leg forward. If you know that's not happening, bring your hand to the inside of your thigh where Kait is. Move that leg to the side once you've got it. And then maybe left hand comes to the side. You can look to your left, test your balance. Good, take a breath. Bring your right leg back out in front of you. Reach both hands back to the ceiling. We're gonna find a chair pose. So just inhale, step your right foot down. Sink your bum back. Good, pause for a moment here. Connect to your core. And bring hands to heart center. Twist to your left. You can hook your right arm on your left thigh. Rotate through your spine. Just take one breath here. Bring your gaze back to the floor, hands plant. You can jump into your chaturanga or step back into your high plank. Just find your flow. Good, meet back in your down dog. Take a breath. On your inhale, right leg floats, open the hip, bend the knee. Hang out in stillness or draw those circles. Find a stillness on your next inhale. Exhale, knee to nose, find your plank. Good, twice more, inhale up. Exhale forward. Inhale up. Exhale forward, step your foot through, find your balance, lift on up, warrior three. Once you arrive, slow the breath. For one inhale, and exhale, and slowly rise to your march. Decide what you want to do on this side might be different. Again, you can wrap peace fingers around big toe or left hand comes to the inside of your thigh. Open up the leg to the side. If you're feeling balanced, your gaze shifts to the right. Take a breath. Unwind back through center. Both arms to the ceiling, take an inhale. Exhale, find your chair pose. Left foot just steps down, bum comes back. Good, inhale here. Exhale, hands to heart. Chin twist towards your right. You can hook left elbow. One breath. On your inhale, start to look down, plant your hands, find your flow. You can jump or step back. Really good. Let's move back in your downward facing. Take a breath. We'll meet in a malasana, so you can either jump your feet to either side of your hands or step one foot forward and then the other. Either way, feet nice and wide, hips low, hands can come apart. Take a breath here. Connect your arms to inner thighs and then palms to one another. Get tall through your spine. Good. If you're comfortable here, we're gonna reach the right arm long, fingertips to the floor, left hand to the ceiling. If you have a bind in your practice, you can reach your hands behind your leg. Either way, take an inhale, roll left shoulder back. Exhale back through center, switch sides. Left hand down, right hand high. Good, big breath. Back through center, two options here. You can either walk your fingertips forward, drop your head, get a nice release. Or if you have a crow or crane in your practice that you're craving, you can plant your hands, lift your hips, bring your knees to the backs of upper arms and play around with an arm balance. And if you're not quite there in your arm balance, a really good drill is to just connect your knees to your arms and do a few heel taps. Either way, you're breathing for one more. Good, if you're in your crow or crane, you can jump back into your chaturanga. If you're folded, just walk your hands back under you. And same thing, we'll either step or jump back, move through your flow. Good, come back to your downward facing. Inhale, come high on your toes, look forward. Exhale, find your forward fold. We'll hang out here for a second. You can choose what forward fold you want. Maybe you want to interlace your hands behind you, stretch out through your shoulders, your chest. If you want to make it more of an active fold, you can hook peace fingers again around big toes. Pull your elbows to the sides. Whatever feels like a nice release. One breath. Good. Gently let go of whatever grip you had. Inhale, take a half lift. Exhale to fold. Just plant your fingertips. You're going to step your left foot back, not too far. We're going to find a wide fold. So just turn to face the wide edge of your mat. Once you're there, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Drop your head completely. Left hand's gonna come towards right foot, maybe on the floor, maybe on right ankle. And then right hand to the ceiling. Maybe to low back, whatever feels better. Continuing to just rotate through your spine. You might feel a little inner thigh stretch here. Good, one breath. Unwind your twist, both hands to the floor. Turn your toes out slightly. We'll find a surfer's lunge at the back of your mat. So left leg bends, hips come nice and low. If you're comfy, your hands to heart, kind of like a half malasana. You can do that same stretch we did, left hand down, right hand high. Good, one breath here. Hands come back to heart center. Can you root into your left heel? We're gonna stand all the way up. Straighten both legs, arms to the ceiling. And then come back into your wide fold. Hinge forward, hands down. For this round, if you have an inversion in your practice that you're craving today, you can bring your head down or forearms and float on it. Or you can hang out in your forward fold. Either way, you're breathing big. One more breath. If you came up, lower your feet down slowly. We'll all meet in a halfway lift, so just bring your hands under you, half lift. Exhale, walk your hands back to frame the top of your mat. Good, find your flow, right foot steps back. Move with your breath.
We stood steady as the stars in the woods.
Good, on your next inhale, hand the toes, look forward. Exhale, find your forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Good. We're not here for too long, but again, you can find whatever version of a fold you want. The more we keep coming back to this, the comfier it should feel, so feel free to change it up. And you've noticed you have more space. For one more breath. And then release. Inhale, find your half lift, fingertips down, right foot steps back. Just find your wide fold facing the other side of your mat. And then start to find your twist. Right hand comes towards left foot on the floor or on your ankle. And then left hand to ceiling or low back. Good. Do what you can here to keep your weight kind of right in between your toes and your heels. You'll feel a nice big stretch in your hamstrings there. For one more breath. And unwind hands to the floor. Start to turn your toes out a bit so you can bend into your right leg. Find your surfer's lunge at the back. Good. If you're comfy here, right hand down, left hand high. Big breath. Good. Unwind hands back to heart. Root into your right heel. Stand tall. And then find that hinge again. Fold forward. Anything you want to do here, if you want to come back into that inversion, if you want to play with something different, go for it. I haven't done a headstand in a really long time. I feel like it hurts my head now. If you feel a lot of weight in your head, you should be pushing more weight into your hands. Take one more breath wherever you are. We'll plant the feet back down. Inhale, find a half lift. Exhale, walk back to the top of your mat. Find your flow, left foot steps back. Move with your breath. Good. Pause for a moment here. I want you to check in with your energy, your breath. We're nearing the end of practice. If you've got a little bit left buzzing in you and you want to keep moving, you're welcome to do a few more flows here or any other inversions or things you want to do upright. When you are ready, we'll meet on our back. So take your time to flow it out if you're in the mood. And then when you're ready, come to your seat the same way we've been doing it, either jump or step through. Once you're on your back, let's find legs up the wall so you can just send your heels to the ceiling. Get nice and flat in your spine. Arms can just rest. Slow the breath down. Right away, if you're like, this is my happy place, I wanna stay here, I'm done moving, feel free to stay, especially if you've got a wall nearby and you wanna just scooch on up to it. If you want a few more quick releases, we're gonna hug your knees in towards your chest. Find a supine twist, let both legs fall to the left, gaze to the right. Once you get here, try to release all effort. We've done quite a bit of twisting today, so things should feel a little more comfortable than maybe 30 minutes ago. Can you soften right shoulder, right hip? Slowly come through center, switch sides. Once you get there, relax everything down. Close your eyes and just breathe. Breaths here. Is there anything you can do to soften? Good. When you're ready, come back through center. Hug your knees in towards your chest. Any last little releases, squeezes, rolls, whatever you need here, find it. And then when you're ready, we'll come into our final shape, whether or not that's Shavasana is up to you. Anywhere you can be comfy. Come back to your breath for a few moments. If you'd like, right hand to belly, left hand to heart. Close the eyes. Start to just focus on your breath. On your next exhale, can you empty out the breath completely? And we'll breathe together. Inhale for 3, 2, 1, pause. Exhale, 3, 2, 1, pause. Inhale, 3, 2, 1, pause. Exhale, 3, 2, 1, pause. Last round. Inhale, 3, 2, 1, pause. Exhale, 3, 2, 1, release your breath completely. Allow it to come back to a natural flow in and out. Hopefully noticing a little bit more space, a little bit more ease in the breath. A little more calm, focus in the mind. little more energy and space in the body. Take one more breath to show yourself gratitude for showing up on your mat today and doing something really good for your body. Breathe all that gratitude in. Exhale, release anything you don't want to take with you off your mat. You can flutter your eyes open if they were closed. You're more than welcome to stay on your mat a little bit longer. Thank you, as always, so much for moving with me. And thanks, Kait, for joining us today. Till next time, have a really great rest of your day.
We stood at your front door. You looked at me and said, baby, this rain.